Mayday, mayday, mayday! Total criminals have seized control of the government.
Today, the United States, Britain, and Canada plan to announce a coordinated set of sanctions against Iran. ABC News and The Wall Street Journal report the sanctions will target Iran's oil and petrochemical industry. Last weekend, President Obama warned no options were being taken off the table.
The sanctions have enormous bite and enormous scope, and we're building off the platform that has already been established. The question is, are there additional measures that we can take? And we're going to explore every avenue to see if we can solve this issue diplomatically. I have said repeatedly, and I will say today, we are not taking any options off the table.
International pressure has been mounting on Iran since the UN International Atomic Energy Agency revealed in a report the, quote, possible military dimensions to its nuclear activities. The IAEA said credible evidence, quote, indicates Iran has carried out activities relevant to the development of a nuclear explosive device. The IAEA passed a resolution Friday expressing, quote, increasing concern about Iran's nuclear program following the report's findings. The Speaker of Iran's parliament said yesterday Iran would review its relations with the IAEA following the report. Ali Larijani indicated it may be difficult for Iran to continue to cooperate with a nuclear watchdog.
If the agency acts within the framework of the charter, we accept that we are a member of it and will carry out our responsibilities. But if the agency wants to deviate from its responsibilities, then it should not expect the other's cooperation.
Iranian parliamentary speaker. Meanwhile, some Iranians have expressed the desire for increased cooperation with the IAEA.
Considering the fact that the government has made plenty of clarifications, it would be better for it to expand its cooperation with the IAEA and let them see for themselves, close up, so there would be no pretext for the superpowers.
Last week, the Pentagon confirmed it has received massive new bunker-busting bombs capable of destroying underground sites, including Iran's nuclear facilities. The 30,000-pound bombs are six times the size of the Air Force's current arsenal of bunker-busters. The new sanctions against Iran also follow last month's allegations by the United States that Iranian officials were involved in a thwarted plot to kill the Saudi ambassador to Washington. The U.S. is expected to announce today that Iran's financial sector is of primary money laundering concern. This phrase activates a section of the USA Patriot Act that warns European, Asian, and Latin American companies they could be prevented from doing business with the United States if they continue to work with Iran. Well, to talk more about the sanctions and the implications of the IAEA report, we go to Washington, D.C. to speak with Pulitzer Prize-winning investigative journalist Seymour Hersh. He's been reporting on Iran and the bomb for the past decade. His latest piece is titled Iran and the IAEA. It's in The New Yorker. Welcome to Democracy Now, Sai. Talk about what you feel should be understood about what's happening in Iran right now in regards to its nuclear power sector.
Well, you mentioned going in. By the way, the piece was in the blog. It wasn't in the magazine. It was on the webpage. But you mentioned Iraq. This is almost the same sort of, I don't know if you want to call it a psychosis, but it's some sort of a fantasy land being built up here, as it was with Iraq. The same sort of no lessons learned, obviously. Look, I have been reporting about Iran, and I can tell you that since 2004, under George Bush and particularly the Vice President, Mr. Cheney, Cheney was particularly concerned there were secret facilities for building a weapon, which are much different than the enrichment. We have enrichment in Iran. They've acknowledged it. They have inspectors there. There are cameras there, et cetera. This is all. Iran's a signatory to the Nonproliferation Treaty. Nobody's accusing them of any cheating. In fact, the latest report that everybody's so agog about also says that, once again, we find no evidence that Iran has diverted any uranium that it's enriching. And it's also enriching essentially to very low levels for peaceful purposes, so they say, 3.8%. And so there is a small percentage being enriched to 20% for medical use, but that's quite small, also under cameras, under inspection. What you have is in those days, in 04, 05, 06, or 07, even until the end of their term in office, Cheney kept on having the Joint Special Operations Force Command, JSOC, They would send teams inside Iran. They would work with various dissident groups, the Azeris, the Kurds, even Jandela, which is a very fanatic Sunni opposition group. And they would do everything they could to try and find evidence of an undeclared underground facility. We monitored everything. We have incredible surveillance. In those days, what we did then, we can even do better now. And some of the stuff's very technical, very classified, but I can tell you there's not much you can do in Iran right now with us without us finding out something about it. They found nothing, nothing, no evidence of any weaponization. In other words, no evidence of a facility to build the bomb. They have facilities to enrich, but not separate facilities for building a bomb. This is simply a fact. We haven't found it if it does exist. It's still a fantasy. We still want to think, many people do think it does. The big change was in the last few weeks, the IAEA came out with a new report, and it's not a scientific report, it's a political document. It takes a lot of the old allegations that have been made over the years that were looked at by the IAEA under the regime or the directorship of Mohammed El-Baradei, who ran the IAEA for 12 years, the Egyptian. He won a Nobel Peace Prize for his work. Somebody who was very skeptical of Iran in the beginning and became less so as Iran was more and more open. But the new director of the IAEA, a Japanese official named Amano, from a center-right party in Japan. I'm sure he's an honorable guy. He believes what he believes. But we happen to have a series of WikiLeaks documents from the American embassy in Vienna, one of the embassies in Vienna, reporting on how great it was to get Amano there. This is last year. These documents were released by the Julian Assange's group and are quite important because what the documents say is that Amano has pledged his fealty to America. I understand he was elected as he's a marginal candidate. We supported him very much. Six ballots. He was considered weak by everybody, but we pushed to get him in. We did get him in. He responded by thanking us and saying he shares our views. He shares our views on Iran. He's going to be it was just an expression of love. He's going to do what we wanted. This new report has nothing new in it. This isn't me talking. This is in the piece I did for the New Yorker blog. It's different for the blog because it has more reporting in it. I talked to former inspectors. There are different voices than you read in the New York Times and the Washington Post. There are other people that don't get reported who are much more skeptical of this report, and you just don't see it in the coverage. So what we're getting is a very small slice in the newspaper, mainstream press here, of analysis of this report. There's a completely different analysis, which is very little new. And the way it works, Amy, is over the years, a report will show up in a London newspaper that'll turn out to be spurious, it'll turn out to be propaganda, whether started by us or a European intelligence agency, it's not clear. This all happened, if you remember the Ahmed Shalabi stuff during the buildup to the war in Iran, all about the great arsenals that existed inside Iran. The same sort of propaganda is being used now, pardon me, I have a slight cold, that shows up over the years, over the last decade in various newspapers. The IAEA would look at it, rule it not to be a fabrication or certainly not to be supportable by anything they know. All of these old reports, with the exception of, I think, in the new study that was put out by the IAEA, there were maybe 30 or 40 old items with only three things past 2008, all of which many people inside the IAEA believe to be spurious, not very reliable fabrications. So there you are.
So, Cy Hirsch, you're saying that it's not new information, it's a new head of the IAEA that's making the difference here. Can you talk more about U.S. infiltration of Iran, JSOC and Iran surveillance as well in Iran?
Sure. I mean, the kind of stuff they did. I could tell you stuff that that was secret 8, 9 years ago. We would, for example, we developed, if there was an underground facility we thought was where we saw some digging, let's say, in a mountain area, we would line the road when there were trucks going up and down the road. We would line the road with what seemed to be pebbles. In fact, they were sensors that could measure the weight of trucks going in and out. If a truck would go in light and come out with heavy, we could assume it was coming out with dirt. They were doing digging. We did that kind of monitoring. We also put all sorts of passive counters, measures of radioactivity, uranium, even plutonium. Most of the stuff that's being done there is enriched uranium. They're not making plutonium.